Ah, yes, MBE. It actually stands for Molecular-Beam Epitaxy System. It's a big vacuum chamber with several thermal evaporation sources. The sources are all aimed at a center point where you put a substrate. We can change the electrical properties, the optical properties, the thermal properties. I sometimes explain it as it's a way of spray painting with atoms. And by engineering these stacks of layers that we're building up with the spray painting process, we actually make what is the first stage of a working either electronic or optoelectronic device.
Every morning, Bob comes in, and the first thing he does is he calibrates his source cells by looking at the kSA 400.
I actually did try a competitor's instrument when I first set that machine up. To use a technical term, it sucked eggs. You know, I looked at the kSA 400 in particular at the time was a really powerful tool at a good price for analyzing electron diffraction patterns in an MBE.
And the 400 makes it extremely easy for him to get the data from the diffraction pattern, analyze it, and tell him what his growth rate is. You know, I'm guessing it takes him probably 5-10 minutes at most.
Bandit I use on a regular basis.
The only tool that I know of that allows you to measure low temperature substrate growth is the Bandit system. It does things that no other temperature monitoring tool can do.
Maintaining the control of those low temperatures to within, say, plus or minus 10 degrees roughly is absolutely critical to getting reproducible material quality.
You can really fine-tune the quality of the end device that you want to grow.
What the MBE makes, or what I make with the MBE, I kind of compare to plankton. Doesn't sound very appealing or sexy, but you know what? Everything else in the ocean dies without good plankton to eat. The plankton not only has to be edible, it has to be really nutritious, or the orca, meaning the terahertz system at the top of the food chain, floats belly up in the ocean. Pretty graphic way of putting it, right?
To have that real-time control to then make a better end device is what Picometrix needs, and it's a very powerful way to control your end product.